FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris or Tim. A section of members of parliament have supported the removal of army representatives from parliament, saying that it is difficult for them to perform any role in a multi-party setting. This as the House of Parliament last evening continued its debate on the report of the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee on the Constitutional Amendment Bill that was brought by the MP Wilfred Niwagaba. Niwagaba, in his proposal, wants army representation to be scrapped, but the committee report recommended that they should be maintained, but as ex-officials as they are mainly listening posts. The members of parliament noted that being a listening post is not part of the roles of members of parliament, and also noted that the army under the constitution is supposed to be neutral and hence have no duty in a multi-party system of parliament.
If the army is here to listen to us, it is okay. Now, if they listen to us, where do they take those stories? Why don't that person come here to listen?
So in a multi-party parliament like ours, they cannot avoid, they say they are merely listening posts, but I've witnessed a number of them speaking here, Madam Speaker. And
we therefore decided that there must be a government side and opposition side. Now, when you bring the army in, they are at a loss.
The MPs also supported the proposal to introduce a panel of speakers, with the Speaker Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga wondering why government is dragging its feet.
Right Honourable Ayume, the second speaker of this country after the new constitution, was the first one to request for the panel. And again, it was in different ways, it was blocked. In the 2005 amendment of the constitution, again it was voted and again it was... So, it's a request that has come from the presiding officers of this house over time. I think they should listen to us.
Members of Parliament have expressed their dissatisfaction with the selective compensation of Ugandans in different parts of the country. This after the Adjumani Woman Member of Parliament, Jessica Alabiku, raised a matter of national importance in which she tasked the Prime Minister to clarify on when the government plans to compensate the victims of the Lord's Resistance Army from the Madi sub-region, since all other regions have been compensated.
Therefore, right Honourable Speaker, my prayer is let government give us a feedback about the promise over this compensation. And we need to know when exactly this promise is going to be implemented.
The first Deputy Prime Minister, Moses Ali, informed Parliament that he will take up the matter, but he cannot promise anything.
Madam Speaker, I will get information what I have, but I will not promise, because what I will must bring here must agree, must tally with that in the government.
Now, this prompted other members of parliament to demand that the government stops the selective compensation of Ugandans, saying that every region deserves to be compensated.
The matter of compensation is a matter that touches more individuals. We need to know the way forward on compensation.
The whole country needs to be compensated at a go. No, this discriminative and selective kind of handling things. No, Tesla is waiting for the cows.
The Acting Executive Director, UNBS, David Livingstone Ebiru, wants the National Council for Higher Education to include standards and quality studies in the curriculum of universities. Ebiru says that if the students get exposed to standards and quality at an earlier stage, they will appreciate its importance to the country and will ease the work of UNBS. He made the call at an award-giving ceremony of the 2020 Africa Regional Standards Organization ESSEC competition, which was won by a Ugandan. Goldie Desire Abesiga from Makerere University, as well as Marvin Steven in Subuga, the winners of the competition received plaques, certificates and cash prizes of $1,000 and $800 respectively.
Going forward, we need to streamline quality standards in our educational system. We are collaborating with the National Council of Higher Education to see whether some programs can be designed to include some course contents in the areas of standards and quality, and therefore want to make sure that our students start appreciating the issues of quality standards at university level before they get out to the job market.
In world news, customs authorities in Germany and Belgium have seized a record amount of cocaine, more than 23 tons, that was destined for the Netherlands, worth billions of euros. German officials discovered 16 tons in five shipping containers that had arrived in the port of Hamburg from Paraguay earlier this month. Police in the Netherlands were notified and a further 7.2 tons of cocaine was seized at the Belgian port of Antwerp. German officials say the cocaine had a street value of billions of euros. A 28-year-old man suspected of involvement in the trafficking of the drugs has been arrested in the Netherlands, Dutch police said on Wednesday. Now in sports, Uganda's under 20 football team, the Hippos, will be back in action today while playing Burkina Faso in the quarterfinals of the under 20 AFCON finals at the Cheikh Boudia Stadium in Mauritania at 10 p.m. Hippos reached this stage after finishing second in their group in Group A, where they defeated Mozambique and Mauritania, but lost to the group leaders, Cameroon. Head coach Mole Biekwaso says they are facing a physical side, but they will do whatever it takes to win this game.
We are facing Burkina Faso, the team which is very, very hard and serious to beat. We think it's going to be a very, very strong game to meet a team which we've never played before. I think it's going to be one of the hardest games than the one we played against Cameroon. Our graph is perfect now because we've tested the good and the bad. We've won, we've lost. I think now we are very, very confident to come for every situation. We are looking forward to playing a good game.
And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.